Alright, not only these two equations look similar, but they're also pretty tricky. The first one is the square root of 2x plus 5 equals I, and for the second one, we have the same square root, but this time it's equal to negative 1. And you know the deal. Please pause the video and try these two questions first. Done? Okay, let's take a look at the first one. We have 2x plus 5 inside the square root. How do we get rid of the square root? Well, just square both sides, right? So let's go ahead and do that. Square, square root cancel, and we just have the inside, which is 2x plus 5, and that's equal to I. I to the second power is equal to negative 1, because that's the definition of the imaginary unit I. Then we can just go ahead and do the usual business, minus 5 on both sides, and then 2x equals this and that is negative 6. Then divide both sides by 2, and we see x is equal to negative 3. Okay, pretty good, huh? For the second one, it looks like we can just do the same thing, isn't it? Well, let's try. Can we still square both sides? It looks like it, because the square, square root cancel, and we still get the inside 2x plus 5. Be careful this time, negative 1 square means negative 1 times negative 1, we get positive 1. All right, let's go ahead, minus 5 on both sides, and then 2x equals this and that is negative 4, and then divide both sides by 2. In this case, we have negative 2. Sure, of course, different answers because there are different questions, but I will tell you, one of them is actually not correct. Which one? This one is actually not correct. And this one is actually legitimate. Why? Let me show you. Let's just go ahead and plug in this number into the original expression and check. Whenever we are dealing with a square root equation, it's always a good habit to check. So when we do that, put negative 3 in here, we are going to get square root of 2 times negative 3 and then plus 5. Will that give us I? Well, let's see. Here we have negative 6 plus 5. That's negative 1. And then take the square root of that. Do we get I? Yes. Done. But if you take a look at the first one, I mean this one, what if we plug in negative 2 into the original equation? Then in that case, let's go ahead. We see that square root of 2 times negative 2 and then plus 5. Will that give us negative 1? Well, this right here is negative 4 plus 5 is positive 1. And we're looking at positive 1 inside of the square root, and we're saying that's equal to negative 1. Again, earlier, this times that gives us negative 6. So that's negative 1, but this time it's positive 1. Square root of 1? No, this right here, we are always going to get a positive outcome. This right here is not correct. So I will just cross this out. So, be really careful, don't just square both sides of the equations all the time. In fact, whenever you square both sides of an equation, you may end up with some fake answers, such as this right here. Extraneous answers, but I like to say them fake answers because these are the answers that they don't work. It's just like you buy stuff on eBay. When you receive them, you realize, oh, they're actually fake. Same thing. That's it.